Hello children, I hope you all are doing good. In today's video, we are going to learn about a computer mouse. A computer mouse looks like a real mouse. It also has a tail. A tail is in form of a wire. This mouse always rests on a mouse pad. We call this as a mouse pad. We use mouse to point and select objects on our screen. So children, a mouse is an input device. Today we are going to see different types of mouse and the action performed on this mouse. A computer mouse are of two types. One is with a wire. And one is without a wire or a cord. So we call this mouse as a cordless mouse or a wireless mouse. Because you can see that this mouse does not have a wire to it. It is connected using a Bluetooth. Whereas this mouse is connected with a wire to the CPU. So children, you all have seen the two types of mouse. This mouse is called as a optical mouse. We call them optical mouse because it uses light for its movement. Every time you move the mouse, the pointer on the screen also moves. You can move the mouse up, down, left and right on the screen. Now let us learn how to hold a mouse. If you are a right-handed person, you place your index finger on the left button of the mouse and your middle finger on the right button of the mouse. Your thumb and your other two fingers are used for holding the mouse firmly. And this is how you hold the mouse and move it. But if you are a left-handed person, you use your index finger on the right button of the mouse and your middle finger on the left button of the mouse. Your thumb and your other two fingers are used to hold the mouse firmly. So this is how the left-handed person uses a mouse. Children, have you all noticed that when you move a mouse, the arrow on the screen also moves? Where is this arrow? Yes, it's right here. So every time I move this mouse, this arrow also moves. This arrow is called as a mouse pointer. There are three parts for our mouse. We have left button, scroll wheel and a right button. We use right left button to click or select object on the screen. We use right button to perform some actions like opening a file, deleting a file, etc. And we use a scroll wheel to move up and down in the page. There are different actions that we can perform using a mouse. The different actions are: we can right click, left click, double click and drag and drop. Every time you press the mouse button, it makes a click sound. Let us try this. I'm sure students, you all can hear this sound. So every time I press a mouse button, it will make a click sound. To left click, I click on the left button of the mouse. To right click, I click on the right button of the mouse. And to double click, I press on the left button of the mouse two times. This is double click. So we have seen left click, right click and double click. These are the various actions that we can perform on the mouse. Next we have is drag and drop. Drag and drop is used when you want to move folders from one place to the other on the computer screen. Not only folders, children, we can even move pictures and many other things which are there on our computer screen. For example, you want to move a folder called as car racing or chess. Drag and drop is performed on the left button of the mouse. To drag and drop, you press the left button of the mouse and keep it pressed. Then when you want to drop it at a location, you need to release your finger. This is how you drag and you drop. Now let us see this on our screen. For example, we have folders here called as car racing and chess. Now I want to drag and drop these folders in a folder named games. So what do? I click on this folder. I press on the left button of the mouse. Keep it pressed and move the mouse towards the games folder. Now my folder is moved over the games folder. To drop it, I release my left finger. Sorry, the index finger. So you children, you can see that the car racing folder from here is dropped in games folder. To perform the same action on this folder named chess, you click on the folder. Which click? Yes, it is left click. Then you move the folder or drag the folder. That is, you need to drag the mouse towards the games folder and then drop it here. To drop, you need to release your finger. Now you see, children, that both our folders have moved to games folder. So this is how you perform drag and drop. Children, we can make use of mouse for different purposes. For example, when our keyboard is not working, we make use of on-screen keyboard. Now, what is on-screen keyboard? On-screen keyboard is a keyboard which is on your computer screen. And to type on an on-screen keyboard, you need a mouse. Only with the help of a mouse we can type on-screen keyboard. A mouse is also used for playing games. We can select different games from a list of games. It also helps us to pause and restart a game. A mouse is also used for drawing pictures. Just like we have a pencil, while drawing, a mouse also acts like a pencil. We can also select colors on our computer screen with the help of a mouse. Mouse is also used for playing audio and video files. What are audio and video files? Your audio files are those files which have songs, only music. And video files have moving pictures on them. So movies, cartoons are all our video files. So children, I hope you all have enjoyed today's topic. Stay home and stay safe till your next class.